assurance we may always hold to in what we do through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Then Peter entered Cornelius, met him, and falling at his feet, paid him homage. Peter, however, raised him up, saying, "Get up. I myself am also a human being." Then Peter proceeded to speak and said, "In truth, I see that God shows no partiality. Rather, in every nation, whoever fears him and acts uprightly is acceptable to him." While Peter was still speaking these things, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who were listening to the word. The circumcised believers who had accompanied Peter were astounded that the gift of the Holy Spirit should have been poured out on the Gentiles also, for they could hear them speaking in tongues and glorifying God. Then Peter responded, "Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people who have received the Holy Spirit, even as we have?" He ordered them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Power.
Beloved, let us love one another, because love is of God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent his only Son into the world so that we might have life through him. In this is love. Not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as expiation for our sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment. Love one another as I love you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends, because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you chose me, but I who chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, you may give you. This I command you, love one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
How do you spell love? G-O-D. The scripture tells us that God is love. Now the real challenge is understanding that up here and letting what's up here make the long journey down to what's over here, the head to the heart. Otherwise, it's only a fact that doesn't have any real impact on us. It may take some people years for the love of God to actually touch them in the center of their being, but it's worth it. There's a priest in Erie, Pennsylvania named Father Larry Richards, who has really distinguished himself over the years. He's a wonderful speaker, and he's written a number of things. But one of the things that he has available, it's on his website, Father Larry, I think it's Father Larry, is the first part of the address. It's the exercise to open up one's heart to the love of God by imagining Jesus as hugging us and staying in that posture for a while. Now, the reason for that is because love is healing. And growing up, people are often hurt by other people. And even to be one's parents, because they're not perfect, and nobody can love us the way God loves us, and didn't give us enough love, or we didn't think they did. So we need to avail ourselves of God's love at a deeper level than just what's up in our minds. Now, how do we know that God loves us on a daily basis when we're not doing something religious, praying, and so forth? It takes a discerning eye to recognize God's love for us because he can be quite subtle. That's just the way he is. Anytime somebody says a kind word to us, helps us in any way, reaches out to us, offers assistance, supports us, forgives us, so forth, these people are instruments of God's love. But we might let all that pass by without really taking much notice of it, and at the end of the day be tempted to think, well, nothing happened today of any significance. I don't know whether God loves me or not. There are so many examples of God reaching out to people on a given day. But we have to think about what happened to us earlier in the day, what people we encountered, what people said, and how people built us up. Families are ideal venues for experiencing the love of God on a human level. So it's something to think about, because otherwise we can go through life empty. We don't know that God loves us on a practical level, but he does. Mother Teresa, who worked, of course, with the very abjectly poor in the streets of Calcutta, said that the greatest poverty today is loneliness, which is a very interesting statement. You won't hear any politician ever talk that way, probably. Poverty is usually associated with the lack of material goods. She connected it with the lack of love, because the people she worked with largely were people who no one loved. They had no one. She was the one who filled the void. But see, God was working through her and through her sisters. I remember one time visiting a community founded by Mother Teresa, one of the convents. This is one that's located right outside of St. Peter's Square in the Vatican. I was happy to go inside, and I gave a little donation to the sisters there. But that's where they are located, doing the work of God amid people who otherwise would not know love at all, because most of the society of people with means ignore them. Everybody knows someone who's perhaps ignored by other people. A person who doesn't have too many friends, for example. Those are the kind of people we should be thinking about, not that we don't think about our friends. But we can reach out to people, especially if we understand that they don't have too many people who care about them. So we can be instruments of God to other people, as well as other people being instruments of God to ourselves. Living a life of love means living a life that is open to God. And God has great plans for people. He loves us so much that He wants us to share His life forever after we die. He loves us so much that He gave us commandments and guidelines for life. He loves us so much that He sent His Son who offered Himself on behalf of sinners. He loves us so much that Jesus founded a church for us, which is a flock. He loves us so much that He gave us the sacraments of the church, including, of course, the sacrament of penance, so that we could be healed of the ill effects of our sins, that we could be liberated from living lives brokenness, so that we could be made new. He loves us so much that He doesn't merely want us to be good, but He wants us to be alive. And this is what love does. Love bears fruit. Goes out of itself, and it gives life. We have a God who gives life to us, the life that we received when we were conceived, and new life that comes to us through the grace of the Holy Spirit. So today we are mindful of the great mystery of our resurrection in Jesus, all that it means. It gives hope to the world because this is what God's love does. We never take it for granted. Many people take God's love for granted, but they don't notice it, they don't know how to discern it, and they even give it up on life. A good deal of modern living is empty for many people, and many people live lives of repressed despair. But if we know God's love, we know how to spot it, and we expose ourselves to it and grow in it, then we are prepared to be the people that the world really needs. People of the resurrection. People of new life.
Commandment of love, we may bring God to all people, we pray. may fear God and do what is right in accordance with their consciences. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the U.S. Supreme Court will recognize marriage as an exclusive union between a man and a woman and not legalize any redefinition that would corrupt what God has designed. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For married people, that each day, through joy and sorrow, they may take to heart the Lord's command to love one another. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our mothers, who have given us life and love, that we may show them reverence and love, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick especially, Betty Dingle, Catherine Barish, Jean Caruso, Sister Maureen Stillane, Jim Sasiak, Nancy Zukoski, Bob Hurt, Mary Miller, Marilyn Runewald, and Jerry Berta, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Charlene Humming, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, receive our prayers with that same love with which you sent your Son to be the sacrifice that takes away our sins. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Second collection is for the Office of Catechetical Services.
The offertory hymn can be found in your gather books, number 699. We have been told.
I have loved you. As the Father has loved me, so I
233, one communion law.
Thank you.
special blessing for the mothers. Loving God is a mother, gives life and nourishment to her children, so you watch over your church. Bless these women that they may be strengthened as Christian mothers. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them always with the spirit of profound respect through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
In the Spirit, we are one in the Lord, and we